Research into language use on Twitter. Three-dimensional reconstructions of archaeological sites. Finding patterns in classical Latin texts. These are all examples of digital humanities. Humanities research with a modern digital twist. This research field is so promising and could have so much impact that the University of Groningen will be starting a master's degree program in digital humanities in September.
The strength of the program is that it learns students to combine traditional humanities research with computational and information science. They will be skilled at looking at data in new ways using digital methods and digital tools. But not only analyzing data will be a part of the program, another part of the program will be that they learn to reflect on a more theoretical and on a more critical level what it means, this big data in contemporary society. You may use the computers to recognize patterns in tweets, for instance, but not only social media data, but also in old handwritten manuscripts. Or you may use digital tools for exploring the Dead Sea Scrolls, or for instance, sound toll registers from the 15th century that are now online accessible for historical analysis. So basically, digital humanities can be a very interesting field for all kinds of scholars from the humanities, whether they are philosophers or historians or anthropologists or archaeologists.
One example of digital humanities is the research conducted by Raf Praat and Johannes Bierva, a classicist and a computer linguist respectively. Together, they achieved results that would otherwise not have been discovered.
This is Cassiodorus, one of the main sources for my research as researcher on late antique historiography. And the problem with Cassiodorus and his colleagues is that he produced a huge amount of sources and letters which are actually impossible for the traditional historian to read in a lifetime. I developed together with my colleague Johannes Bierva a digital solution to this, namely Cassio Digitalis.
We begin with this collection of texts, which is scanned text from Raf's letter collections from the late antique period. We then pass it through our program, which we made in order to discover these associations between, for instance, ancient rulers and Cassiodorus himself and certain historical concepts. And what that results in is a heat map like this, where you can see that the Ostrogothic king Theodoric has a much lower association with the concept of gothness compared to his two predecessors, Alaric and Odovaker, who have a very high association with gothness. Now, using this method, we were able to, in a matter of a few hours, corroborate what historians have learned after years of study. So this project clearly shows the potential of using cross-disciplinary work in the digital humanities.